So I'm Paul Bailey, Supercar Driver member and serial Supercar Collector. Today we're here at Blyton Park and with the McLaren P1 and we're out doing passenger rides for those people who want to experience the performance, the braking and the roll holding of one of the most amazing supercars that money can buy today. Introduce my McLaren P1. As you can see here, it's chassis number 19. It's the first UK car and the second car globally. So why did I get such an early car? I think the reason is that McLaren knew that I was going to use the car, and today I'm out giving passenger rides and giving people the experience of such a fantastic piece of kit. So let me tell you about the spec of my P1. So the car is spec'd in Volcano Orange, which was the launch colour at the Geneva Motor Show. And I chose this colour because I think if you're going to buy an outrageously fantastic car, you need to have it in an outrageous fantastic colour. And that just about sums it up. How would I compare the McLaren P1 to some of the other supercars I've got in the collection? I think it's quite amazing how the McLaren P1 has advanced since cars such as the Porsche Carrera GT and the Ferrari Enzo, for which I'm lucky enough to have both of those. I think that the biggest difference is hybrid mode, and if you'd have asked me prior to ownership if I would ever have used battery mode, I would have said no. But in fact I use it as much as I can. So when the hell do you use battery mode on a supercar? Well, leaving early in the morning, coming home late at night, stop-start traffic on the motorway, and if you want to get economy out of the car, it's quite amazing. In the extended range mode, 31 miles to the gallon is pretty impressive for a car with over 900 brake horsepower, and that's what I'm currently getting out of the P1. So it's got a range of features that just simply could not have been thought about 10 years ago, when the Carrera GT and the Enzo came out. Now, how do these cars compare in terms of performance? Well, the delivery of the McLaren P1 is very different. Because of the hybrid capability, it fills the gap that you would not have in a normal combustion engine, particularly when you're changing gear. So you end up with very linear power delivery, and that means that the 0 to 30, the 0 to 60, the 0 to 100, the 0 to 150, the 0 to 200 are all much quicker than the other vehicles that I'm lucky enough to own. How's the day gone at Blyton Park? How's the McLaren P1 performed? Well, to be fair, the McLaren P1 performs in exactly the way that it says on the tin. The car has shown the clients today the phenomenal acceleration. We've been on the back straight, getting up to about 165 on the back straight, which is pretty good. At the end of the straight is a very sharp left, so you've got to make sure you've got enough space to brake and get around the corner. We've also gone through the chicane halfway down the back straight, so we've given both of those experiences. We've been able to really explain to the clients just how good the Accobino brakes are. When you look at those brakes on the P1, they don't necessarily look like they're carbon fibre, they look like they're steel. But in fact, they are carbon fibre, and they are the same brakes that are supplied to many of the Formula One teams. We've also taking the car around the corners at speed. I haven't been able to use the car in full race mode today because the track isn't quite smooth enough and there's a couple of raised corners that will take the front splitter off. But we have been able to get the car moving around and showing people just how good the grip is on the McLaren P1. What else have they experienced? Well, they've also experienced that the passenger footwell plate doesn't have your feet going through it when the passenger tries to brake themselves, which is normally what happens. A nervous passenger uses one foot to brake, and the really nervous ones use both of them, because that is how good the braking is on the P1. So often they come out with their legs aching because they've been doing the braking as much as I have. My business is horsepower racing, and HPR offers two opportunities for our clients. The first is the rental for things like films, music videos, that type of thing. We were very lucky to have 14 cars in Fast and Furious 6. So a lot of the cars that you see in the square where they have the celebrations are HPR cars, and that was a really fantastic booking as well. We've been partnering with Sony recently for a new game they've got coming out, and they've been recording some of the quite fantastic supercars that we've got in the collection. And we also hire the cars out with a chauffeur for important events such as proms, wedding, that type of thing, and that's been really interesting this year. But the core part of the business, the really exciting bit, is the second half, where we give people the opportunity to go on the racetrack as a passenger in some of these supercars and to really experience what they can do, such as the P1. What does 2015 offer for you guys watching this video? Well, I'm going to tell you, it's a global opportunity. Horsepower Racing are exclusively partnering with Supercar Drivers Club to offer you a one-off opportunity. That opportunity will be 5 laps in the LaFerrari, 5 laps in the Porsche 918, and 5 laps in the McLaren P1 on the same day at the same circuit, being driven around those circuits by fully qualified racing drivers. This will give you a unique global experience of being able to look at what these cars are and consider, in your opinion, which offers the best experience. And I think there will be some real surprises when you come and join us on the day.